So far in this class, we've been going all over the place using this PySystem Explorer to explore notifications. But what if you're not interested in keeping this up and running to just look at your notifications? What if you just want some kind of a simple desktop alert? Well, as you might guess, we do have something that satisfies that. If you go into the PySystem menu, when you install the client, this notifications client, one of the things installed is this Py desktop alert. Now, I'm going to go ahead and start it up. You'll notice it appears down in the bottom. At this point, since it's the first time I've run this, I'm not connected to any specific Py server at this point, or Py system, I should say. So let me go ahead and double click on that, and I'm going to specify that this is the server that I'm going to be connecting to. I'll go ahead and choose Apply, and OK. And as you can see, it has picked up that same Active Directory user. In this case, it's the Windows administrator. It's the same Active Directory user that we saw when we looked at MyPy. And as a result, it's telling me I'm looking at two notifications at this point. So what's going to happen if you get a notification? Well, you're going to be able to look at that notification from within this desktop alert. Let me demonstrate. Now, as we've done several times earlier in this class, I'm just going to force a notification for testing purposes using system management tools. I'm going to go into the section called Data. I'll pick the tag that's the trigger. This is a tag that's being referenced. It's an element attribute that's being referenced by a couple of notifications. I think both are the ones I'm subscribed to. And this is how we do it. Now, this really isn't, of course, this isn't a system management class. But if you do have system management tools installed on your machine, and that is a free download from OSIsoft, it's a fairly useful little utility for doing things like this. Okay, the tag, the Py tag, was this one called MyCDT158, I believe. And if we look at the last 2 days, you can see this is what I've been using for testing purposes. Yeah, this is the one where it goes above, if it goes above, what was it, 250, I believe we have an alarm. When it goes above 300, we have a more severe alarm. So I'm going to go ahead and take it out of alarm state. So this should reflect that we no longer have anything in an alarm state at this point. It's still monitoring these tags. There we go. And now watch what happens if I go ahead and I'll push this to, say, 265. That should be above the 250. We should get a notification here. Yeah. As you can see, we just got the little desktop alert saying, hey, take a look at this. We've got some, you know, something to look at. If I go ahead and launch my Py, this will give me a tool that I can use to look at this in more detail. Now, the duration of time in which this appears, you know, when it disappears, etc., all that stuff's available for configuration. And as you can see here, I can see we've got a couple of active alarms here. And just as before, you know, we can choose all those, you know, good things that we want to look at. We want to look at the history, the most recent stuff, all that's available. If I want to drill through or just look at the individual events themselves, I can do that, same as we've done before. Now let's take a look at some of these options here. As you can see, you have a choice of what you actually show. Let me go ahead and reduce this so we don't see the detail. Show you before and after. And let me make this a little bit bigger too. As you can see, now we show over here in this pane what the target is. And if I want to see the full path, then that's something I can choose as well. There we go, that's the full path, so you can kind of figure out where within your hierarchy this alarm is occurring. So those are some options on this end. Now also, you have this option right here. It affects the same pane. You can choose to sort these by categories. I don't have any categories set up in this case, or by status. So, you know, these are the different ways that we can sort what we see over here. Obviously, for two, it's not very important, but if you've got hundreds of alarms or hundreds of notifications, this is a useful feature. Now, let's take a look at what happens when let me go ahead and close this out. That was my archive editor. Let's see what happens when we simply open this up. There's some settings in here we can choose. If I just double click on this, the settings here are for how we get notified, how long that particular notification is going to start. So if you take a look at this preview, you know, that's an example of a 5-second notification. There we go. You can also configure sounds. So, for example, if I would like to have some kind of a, let's just go with the standard Microsoft ding, when the or Windows ding here. If I go into media or Windows media, I'll just go ahead and choose ding. I can't demonstrate it on this virtual machine. I don't have sound to show it to you, but this would be how we'd associate different sounds with a notification. And you have choice of, you know, how do you, how many times do you play that? Do you just keep repeating it until people acknowledge or shut it off? Do you delay that repeat by X number of seconds, etc.? This is what we saw earlier when we had to configure our connection to the Pi server.